In this video, we will highlight the new features we've incorporated into the media browser. Representing a significant upgrade for trakAxPC, this new version is now compatible with all the leading file formats, with support added for AVCHD, .mov, FLV, transparent PNGs, and more. As these new file formats can be very large in size and CPU intensive when previewing, we have added the ability to drop video frames to improve previewing and playing files in the video output screen. This will not affect the viewing experience on high-res files. When you preview a file, you may notice the drop frame meter in the video output window may become active. When the meter is green, the file is playing efficiently. If the drop frame meter turns to amber or red, it is an indication that the CPU is under pressure, and we would recommend that you adjust the drop frames meter until the playback is satisfactory. When previewing a file, we've also added a new seek slider, which allows the user to move through an audio or video file quickly and easily. The slider can also be adjusted in size for precision seeking. You can now also control playing and seeking through a file using the play controls in the video output window. You can now pause a video while playing, as well as accessing any files contained within that folder. You can also preview the file in full screen mode. A very exciting tool we've added is the ability to create photo slideshows in a matter of seconds. This feature can be accessed by right-clicking on a folder which contains photos and selecting Create Slideshow. To learn more about creating a slideshow, please view the Create Slideshow tutorial. Another nice feature is the ability to view the thumbnails of media in both the Scan and Recent File tabs. You can change the thumbnail size by right-clicking in the Scan area and selecting View. Choose an option from the drop-down menu. Finally, an important new feature we've added to the media browser is the ability to access multiple computers on a single network. trakAxPC will automatically find all PCs connected to your network, and if you have permissions, this will allow you to edit and mix media from these PCs. To access a folder or file from a computer on your network, find the computer name and click on the expand icon to access the folders and files. Just to note, some Wi-Fi connections may struggle when playing, parsing, or transferring large files. A cable connection to the router is preferable. One of the major advancements to the media browser is our new Media Manager window. The Media Manager window allows you to see all your files in a thumbnail view, as well as being able to move, copy, delete files and folders on your hard drive, external drives, and network. To access the Media Manager, simply right-click on a folder with media you wish to work with and select View in Media Manager. The Media Manager window will appear. You can resize this window to your liking. You'll be presented with all the folders and files contained within this folder in a thumbnail view. You can easily control the size of each thumbnail by using the thumbnail slider. This is a great way of viewing and accessing your video and images quickly and easily. The number in the top right-hand corner of the window indicates the number of files within this folder. The directory bar simply indicates the location of the folder you're in on the hard drive, external drive, or network. You can use the green back button to move back to its parent's directories. If you want to quickly access a folder you've recently been in, simply click on the Recent Folders icon. You can also browse for a folder using the Browse Folder window. If this folder contains photographs, the Create Slideshow icon will be active. Click on this button if you wish to create a slideshow using these images. Please view the Create Slideshow tutorial to learn more. If you wish to use a file in this folder, you can click on it to preview it and then simply drag the file into a specific location in the mixing window. You are now able to drag multiple files and folders into the mixing window. Dragging multiple files can be done two ways. You can do this by either holding down the Shift key on your keyboard and selecting a group of files in order, or holding down the Control button to select individual files. Once the files are selected, simply drag them to the desired location. You can also right-click in the window and roll over Select to choose an option from the drop-down menu. Choose the file type you wish to use, or select All to highlight all the media in the window. You'll be presented with the Paste Options window. This window indicates which file types are being imported and gives you the flexibility to arrange the files the way you want. Firstly, you can see the number of files that will be placed into the mixing screen for audio, video, and photos, depending on what you have dragged in and their length when they are placed beside each other. The amount of crossfade between segments, or the space between them, can be controlled using the segment spacing slider. Simply moving the slider to the left increases the amount of crossfade, and moving to the right increases the gap between the segments. You can right-click on the slider to align it back to center. You can also select different crossfade types using the crossfade drop-down menu. The segment length slider only controls multiple photographs and will not affect videos. This slider determines the length of each individual photo segment. The time length window indicates the current length of each photo segment. You can also input your desired length, up to a maximum of 10 seconds. Finally, we have the single track and alternating track options, which allows you to place each media group on a single track or alternating tracks. For example, if I select a group of photos and select alternating tracks, you will see one photo followed by the next photo on the channel below, and then alternating between each of these channels. If you select single track, they will all appear on the same channel. When you have made all your adjustments and are happy, click OK. You can also use this Paste Options window if you drag a folder or multiple files directly from the media browser. I will reopen the Media Manager window to show you some more new features. We've added the ability to move and arrange files before you bring them into the mixing window, so they will be arranged in the order you want when placed in the mixing window. Also, some files may not be in their correct orientation. That is, a portrait photo may be in landscape. You can easily rotate this image so that it would always be correct by right-clicking on it and selecting Properties. In the Orientation section, select the correct orientation. If there are more photos in this folder, you can use the Next and Previous buttons so you do not have to continuously open the Properties window. You can also use the Media Manager to organize your files without having to leave the application and use Windows Explorer. Firstly, you can rename a file or folder. You can delete a file or folder from your hard drive, external drive, or network. You can also drag a file or folder to a new folder. This will act like a cut and paste. And finally, you can have multiple Media Manager windows open. In this example, I'll right-click and select Open Duplicate View. In the New Media Manager window, I'll right-click and select New Folder. Give the folder a name and double-click on it to access it. I will then choose my files I wish to copy, right-click on them, and select Copy Selected Items. I will then paste them into my new folder. If I would like, I could simply drag them to the new folder. However, they will be removed from the existing folder and placed into the new folder. You can also copy files from the media browser and paste them directly into a folder in the Media Manager. We hope you find these new features useful, and please view our other new tutorials to learn more.